Hello, this is Kathleen McKee of Aline's.com Machine Embroidery Art. Lesson 1. Setting up your quick access toolbar. When you first install PE Design Next on your computer, the screen is going to look something like this. I have to tell you, I was not too happy with it at first since I was so used to digitizing with PE Design 8 and earlier versions. I was used to having all my most frequently used tools right at my fingertips if I wanted to rotate or if I wanted to see what the stitch type or color was and the outlines. I could just click on them to find out. Not so when you with PE Design Next. You have to go to Arrange to flip it. And then to find out the color, you have to click on it. Then you have to go to Attributes, and then you can see it. So this irritated me until I found out that PE Design Next really is superior, and that you can set up all your most frequently used tools on your quick access toolbar. When you click on a tool, and we'll start with the Select tool, it gives you the option to show the quick access toolbar above the ribbon. You see it moves. Or if you right click, it gives you the option to show it below the ribbon. I prefer mine below the ribbon. Some of I think when you first install it, these are already on the quick access toolbar. So we're just going to go right down the line, and I'm going to start with my Select tool by right clicking it and then left clicking on Add to quick access toolbar. And there it is, with all the same options that it has under the Home tab by the pull down arrow. Since I use keyboard shortcuts for the cut, copy, and paste, I'm not going to take up any space on my quick access toolbar for that. Next, I'm going to right click my text tool, and then I'm going to left click add to quick access toolbar. And there it is, also with the same pull-down, drop-down options as it does under the Home tab. Manual punch, right-click, left-click, same options. Line region, rectangle shape, right-click, left-click, right-click, left-click, right-click, left-click. So there we have all of our sewing tools there that we need. I import a lot of patterns, so I'm going to right-click, left-click that, so I can get that without having to move around. Couldn't live without my Zoom tool. Going to right-click that, left-click, and once again, it has all the options as under the Home tab. I don't use the pan that much. I always use my Measure tool all the time. Right-click, left-click. Couldn't live without that either. Use my design settings a lot. Right click, left click. Don't use the sand too much, so I'm not going to take up any space on the ribbon for that. So we're going to go down to the next tab, the Edit tab. I don't use that one so much. When I do edit a point, I usually right click on that point itself and to change it from a straight to a curve. I do use the group a lot, so I'm going to right click that and then left click to add it to my quick access. The remove overlap, merge, and hole sewing, use them all the time. Right click, left click, right, left, right, left. So there they are. Remove overlap, merge, hole sewing. I use my stamp quite a bit. Right, left, and that's all. So I'm going to go to the next tab, Arrange. I want my flip vertically and horizontally. Right click, left click, right click, left click. Don't really need the rotate, because with PE Design Next you have this little red dot that you can rotate, so I don't need that on my quick access toolbar. It's always accessible. I don't use any of these very often, so I'm not going to take up any space on my ribbon for that. The image, the only thing I need from that is my open the image, because I do use a lot of templates. Right click, left. And I almost never use auto stitch, and if I ever do, I know where to find it, so I'm not going to take up space with that. The view, these tools, they like the sewing, and these toggle on and off, so you can see the stitch simulator. Looking on the bottom of the screen, you can see you can have that turned off. I always have it turned on. Sewing attributes, I always keep that turned on as well. If you look over to your right, you can see, I mean, why would you want to not see your sewing attributes? So I keep those on. Now, this is where it gets tricky. You see, you don't, when you can't see, unless you have something drawn on the board, you're not going to be able to see your attributes. So since I've drawn something on the board already, I can click on it, but it still is not showing like it did in PDesign X, so I have to click on the attributes. Now I can see the bars. And here's where it gets tricky. You need to do each one of these elements separately. You need to right click and then left click to get the line sew on. Then on this little spool of thread, you have to right click and left click to get it on the quick access toolbar. And the same with the line sew type. You have to right click and then left click it. So now we know that it's a line sew, that the pink is on the outside, and it's a zigzag stitch. All right, the same with the line, with the region sew. You have to right click it, add it to the quick access, go to the region color, right click, left click, and also with the region sew, right click, left click. Now, when you have a manual punch and it's blue, it's not showing up there, so you need to click on that, and then it will show you on, under manual punch attributes, and you have to click on the region color. Actually, you don't have to click on the region color because that shows up under the region sew type. You just have to click on the block sew type. Right click and then left click. So now if I want to change my block color, I will go to the region color tab and change it. And if I want to change the stitch type, I can't do it here. I have to do it here and change it. Now I have everything set up just like I want it, except I don't want this select tool over here. It's too close to there. Might as well put it over here where I'll be using it more frequently. So I'm going to right-click that, and then I'm going to remove it from the Quick Access toolbar. And then I'm going to right-click it again, and then I'm going to add it to the Quick Access toolbar. Now it's over here on the other side. I'm probably missing a few tools that I've forgotten about, but as I digitize and as you find you're using more tools frequently or less frequently, you can add or delete them. But that is how you set up the Quick Access toolbar, and it's really nice to have everything at your fingertips. You'll get so used to using it that you'll forget about all these tabs going back and forth. So I hope you have good luck with that.